One positive number is 1/4 of another number. The difference between the numbers is 192. We want to find the numbers. So the first thing we need to recognize here is that there are two numbers, one number, and then another number that is 1/4 the first number. So let's let x equal the first number. And if the second number is 1/4 this number, we can represent the second number as 1/4 x. And then we're told the difference between these numbers is 192. Well, difference means subtraction, so we'll have the equation x minus 1/4 x equals 192. Now we have two like terms that we need to combine before we solve for x. Remember, we can think of this as 1x. Well, 1x minus 1/4 x would of course be an x term. Then the coefficient would be 1 minus 1/4, which is 3/4. And just in case you don't see where this 3/4 came from, we can see it's going to be an x term, and then the coefficient would be 1 minus 1/4, which we can write as 1 over 1 minus 1/4. Then we'd have to have a common denominator, so we'd multiply this first fraction by 4 over 4. So we'd have 4/4 minus 1/4, which would be the 3/4 that we have here. And this is equal to 192. And now to solve for x, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal of 3/4, which would be 4/3. So multiply the left side by 4/3 and the right side by 4/3. Let's go ahead and put this over 1. 3 over 3, 4 over 4, that all simplifies to 1. So we have x equals this product here. Well, 3 does divide evenly into 192. There's 1 3 and 3, and 64 3s in 192. Just go ahead and check that. 192 divided by 3. There's 6 3s in 19. 6 times 3 is 18. Subtract, bring down the 2, and there are 4 3s in 12. So x is going to be equal to this product here. Notice the denominator is 1, so we'll just have 4 times 64, or 64 times 4. That'd be 16, carry the 1, is 24 plus 1, is 25. So x is equal to 256, which would be the first number. Notice the second number is 1/4 times x, or 1/4 times 56, which would be 64. And again, we should recognize this because 64 times 4 did give us 256, so 64 would be 1/4 of 256. Then if you wanted to verify that this was the correct answer, remember the difference has to be 192. So to check this, we would have 256 minus 64, which would give us 192, which verifies our answer is correct. I hope you found this helpful.